For latest updates, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon.
Hello and welcome to the part 3 of this video series on the aviation terminology. In this video, I'm going to talk about the main terms or the words that is used in airline cargo handling. This video is going to be very helpful for the people working in airline cargo industry, freight forwarding, or in the logistics sector. So let us start and understand what are the main terms, common terms that is used in the airline cargo handling industry. Air cargo. Air cargo is the equivalent to the term goods, meaning any property carried or to be carried in an aircraft other than mail, baggage, or property of the carrier, provided that baggage moving under the airway bill. Airway bill. This is the document made out of or on behalf of the shipper, which evidences the contract between the shipper and the airline for carriage of goods over the routes of the airline. All cargo aircraft. An aircraft which carries air freight only, also known as freighter. Allotment. Customer contracted space for cargo on board of specific flights or day. During the booking and flight planning process, this space keeps being reserved for the customer until it is manually or automatically released in case the customer does not use the space. Ancillary equipment. Equipment used to build up a palletized load or to convey a ULD outside an aircraft. For example, dollies, containers, templates, etc. AOG. This is an aircraft when on the ground due to some technical problem where the material has to be expedited for the repair of grounded aircraft. Belly hold. This is the lower deck cargo hold of an aircraft where lower deck loading is done. Bonded goods. Goods on which the custom duty has not yet been paid and which therefore are under the control of custom, usually in a bonded warehouse. Bonded warehouse. This is a depository or for the goods on which the custom duty has not been paid. The warehouse proprietor must provide a bond, often in the form of bank guarantee or a mortgage, to the custom authority as a security for any duties which may not be paid by the customer. Break bulk. This is disassembling of consolidated shipment for a delivery, or this can also be for the purpose of reconsignment of a shipment from the transit point. Break bulk agent. A forwarder breaking the bulk, taking care of breaking the consolidation into their individual parts, or the unpacking and sorting of goods after the flight. Broker. Broker is basically a person who acts an agent or intermediary in negotiating the contracts, sometimes also referred as freight forwarder. Bulk cargo. This is basically loose cargo which is not loaded into the ULD. The bulk cargo loaded into the bulk compartment or a separate unit where the ULD cannot be used. Bulk compartment. Aircraft compartment planned for carrying bulk cargo, which normally you will find at the end of the aircraft compartment where only the bulk cargo is loaded. BUP. This is also known as bulk utilization program. This bulk utilization program where shipper consignee handles the complete units. Customer normally build up the pallets and move it through the airline for the purpose of directly loading into the aircraft. Cabotage. This is basically a traffic originating at a point in one country and also destined at the another point of the same country or the same territory. For example, cargo moving from Mumbai to Ahmedabad. Cargo hold. This is the space in an aircraft confined by ceiling, floors, walls and bulkheads which are used for carrying baggage, cargo and mail either in bulk or in unit load devices, that is called ULD. Cargo IMP, also known as cargo interchange message procedure. In this case, cargo data exchange, automation between the airline and the other party, much more efficiently if the messaging procedures and standards are applied. IATA cargo IMP is the legacy standard for exchanging critical cargo operation information. Cargo IQ. Cargo IQ, basically formally known as Cargo 2000, which is an IATA interest group with the mission of creating and implementing quality standard for the worldwide air cargo industry. Cartage. Cartage is the charge for picking up the delivering goods by surface transportation, example from ramp to warehouse or vice versa. Cargo accounting settlement system, also known as CASH. This is a system of accounting for settling accounts on an air cargo sales between airline on one hand and their intermediaries on the other hand. CCS, that is Cargo Community System. Cargo Community System is the integrating and communication system between all stakeholders handling air cargo at the airport. Certificate of Origin. This is a certificate which provides the country of origin, production of goods used for custom declaration purpose. Charges collect. Charges collect, as stated on the airway bill, to be collected from the consignee at the destination after delivering the goods to the consignee. Charges collect fee. This is a fee assessed on the weight or the valuation charge of charges collect shipment. This fee is payable by the consignee at destination. Charges prepaid. Charges, as stated on the airway bill, for the payment by shipper at origin. Charter. This is the aircraft chartered for the operating purpose by the through the contract between the airline and the charter party. Charter contract. This is a special agreement whereby a carrier places the entire capacity of an aircraft at a shipper disposition. Charterer. Charterer is the person who has signed a charter contract with the airline. Thank you for watching this video, and if you find this video helpful, please share it with your colleagues and friends so that they are also benefited from this knowledge. And once again, if you have not subscribed the channel, please do so, so that you can get notification as and when we upload the new video.
For detailed learning of all logistics subjects, visit www.logivader.com.